Children, there are two types of current. What are the two types of current we get there? One is AC current, and the one is DC current. AC current, okay, in the board exam, they'll ask you what are the differences between AC current and DC current. 5 points, if you write, you'll get 5 marks. So AC means alternating current. Alternating current. DC means direct current. Okay, direct current. Number two difference, children. In AC, polarity changes for every half rotation. Polarity changes. What do you mean by polarity? Means plus becomes minus, minus becomes plus. Polarity changes. In DC, polarity does not change. In DC, polarity does not change. Okay, children. Third one. AC can be sent to, we can send AC to long distances without energy loss. We can send AC to long distances without energy loss. Whereas DC, we cannot send to long distances. Wherever you are producing DC current, there only we should use, children. Okay, AC we can send to long distances. Whatever we are getting in hydropower stations, thermal power stations, they are coming to our house through wires. That is AC current. Our house, we get current is AC current. And DC current means we'll put battery cells in toy cars or in watches or everything. Where you're putting battery and getting the current, that is DC current. There only you should use it. You can't send it to long distances. You can't send DC to long distances because energy loss will be there. Okay, example. What are the sources of AC current? So many times they asked in board exam. Hydropower stations, thermal power stations. Okay, what are the sources? Okay, next, and what are the sources of DC? Cell or battery? All these differences you should write like this for the children. Next, okay, AC graph, if they ask alternating current graph, will be like this, children, because polarity is changing. No? Polarity is changing after every rotation. After every one rotation of this armature, polarity changes two times. After first rotation, plus becomes minus, minus becomes plus. After second rotation, minus becomes plus, plus becomes minus. Okay? For every one rotation, two times polarity changes. I will explain you that briefly, don't worry. For every one rotation, polarity changes two times. Okay? And in DC, the graph remains like this. Graph, because there is no polarity change. Sometimes in board exam, they are giving graph and they are asking you to identify what type of current. If you see like this graph, you should say it is an AC current, alternating current. If you see like this graph, you should say DC current, children. Okay, and last difference, one more difference is there, children. I forgot to give. And most important, in AC, we use, children, in AC, we use full rings. Full rings. Whatever figure is given in your textbook, I told you, the full rings too are there. In AC, we use full rings, whereas in DC, we will use split rings. Split rings means half moon shape, children. Half moon shape, half of rings. Like this, it will be semicircular. Okay, in full rings, we'll use, AC current, we'll use full rings. And in DC currents, we'll use half of rings, we'll use, children. So these are the differences between AC and DC. I will clear your doubts, children. Don't worry, just listen first of all. Okay, so AC means alternating current. In exam, you have to write like this only. Always, if ever they ask compulsory differentiating column, you should write it directly. If you write in points, you will not get marks. AC means alternating current, DC means direct current. Polarity changes, polarity does not change. Polarity means plus becomes minus, minus becomes plus. Okay, and can be sent to long distances, cannot be sent to long distances. Hydropower stations, thermal power stations, cell or battery. And the graph is polarity is changing, that's why it is in waves form, children. Polarity is not changing. Here, in AC, we use full rings, children, full rings. I told you in the figure, you see two full rings are there in the figure. And in DC, we'll use split rings. Split rings means half moon shaped rings we will use. These are the differences between AC and DC. Okay, children, kindly note down in your textbook also, children, all these differences, okay? And I will tell you.